A very good morning, my dear students. Today we will study a new chapter, that is chapter 19, Life Cycle of Stars. It is of 8th standard science, last chapter. So in this chapter we will study about properties of stars, birth of a star, stability of star, evolution of star, and stages of star, etc. In this chapter also, the omitted content due to COVID problem, I will cancel out. So you note down in your book. But exercise, all you have to study, as well as what portion is cancel out, that you have to study yourself, because in exercise anything may come. So let us start with our lecture portion. So children, we are going to start our explanation part in this lecture. Here you can see, children, this portion is cancelled out. Now we will see that our solar system is situated in a galaxy, and a galaxy is a collection of billions of stars. This point you underline, because it may come and you have to study thoroughly all the lessons, because question will come from in between the lesson. So, and interstellar clouds which are present in between the empty spaces of the stars. And the universe is made up of so many such type of galaxies. So first, what you have learned, that our solar system is situated in a galaxy. And galaxy is what? It is the collection of billions of stars, their planetary system, and interstellar clouds which are present in the empty space between the stars. The universe is made up of innumerable such galaxies. And galaxies are different in the structure and shape. So we can divide them into three types. So which are three types? We'll see here: spiral, elliptical, irregular. How is our galaxy? Our galaxy is spiral, and it is called the Milky Way and Mandakini. So these all are the important points. Let us see here. The figure shows a spiral galaxy. This is the spiral galaxy. Our solar system is situated in the same galaxy. Now, if you'll see in the sky at night time, you can see planets, stars, etc. But how did we get information about the other component which are present there in the universe? So to get this all answer, several telescopes are placed on the surface of the earth, and some other are kept aboard man-made satellites which are prepared by man or scientists. These are also orbiting in the earth in fixed orbit. So these telescopes are situated above the earth surface. That is why they can observe astronomical object more effectively. Now we'll see the properties of the stars. At night we can see about 4000 stars without our naked eye, and sun is an ordinary star among them. Why we are telling ordinary, children? Because even though it appears to be larger than the other star, but still, because of its being nearest to us, it is very nearest to us, that is why it is looking so large. But there are billions of stars which are more higher and which have the lower mass size and temperature than those of the sun. So stars are the gigantic sphere of the hot gas. This point you have to underline. Some properties of the sun are given here that you can study, children. Its mass is given, radius is given, surface temperature is given, temperature of the center is given, age is given. And this portion is cancelled out for you. So let us see now. The mass of the sun is about 3.3 lakhs times that of the earth, and its radius is 100 times that of the earth. Other stars have the masses between 1 upon 10 mass of the sun upon 10 and 100 times that of the sun, that is 100 m sun. M mean mass. So this way we can see about this. Now here, do you know this is also cancelled for you? So this is cancelled for you. Now here you can see, children, super giant star is there, sun is there, white dwarf is there, red giant star is there. There is comparison of sizes of different stars. So just imagine in front of the super giant star how sun is so small. Even white dwarf is more smaller than the sun also. The red giant star is so big. So this way we can conclude that our sun is, in comparison of the other, it may be mostly it is smaller, but sometime it is bigger than that. The age of the sun and other stars, which is the time elapsed after their formation, can be between a few million years to a few billion years. So this point you have to underline. If the properties of sun are changed in its lifetime, it would have caused the changes in the properties of the earth and as well as in the life of the earth. Now the properties are the properties of the sun are remain unchanged over its lifetime, that is past 4.5 billion years ago. So what is the life of the sun? 4.5 billion years. Now according to a study which are made by astronomer, these properties will slowly change in further after 4.5 billion years. Now the birth of the star. How a star take birth? How a star is formed? That we'll see. So we are going to study this topic now. Huge clouds of the gas and dust are present in between the empty space, which is between the stars in a galaxy. These are called interstellar clouds. So this is important point you have to underline, children. Now here I'll show you one picture. Scientists use the unit of light year for measuring the large distance. A light year, this also you have to underline because it may come in fill-ups or answer in one sentence. This is very important point. A light year is the distance traveled by the light in 1 year. As the speed of light is 3 lakh kilometer per second, the light year is equal to 9.5 into 10 raised to 12 kilometer. The size of interstellar clouds is about few light years. That is, light takes a few years to go from one end of a cloud to other end. So we can imagine how huge the cloud are. Now, due to some disturbance in these clouds, the clouds start contracting, and because of the contraction the density increases, as well as due to density increase the temperature also increases. And once the temperature and density of the center of a sphere increase sufficiently, the nuclear energy that is generated due to the fusion of atomic nuclei start generating, and because of this energy generation the gas sphere becomes self-luminous and a star is formed. So we can say star is born. In the sun, this energy is generated by fusion of hydrogen nuclei to form the helium nuclei. This means hydrogen at the center of the star act as a fuel and energy generated by burning of the fuel. Now children, this is cancel out, but here you can see the diagram which is up showing a picture of interstellar clouds taken by Hubble Space Telescope. So Hubble Space Telescope is a type of telescope that you will study in 9th standard. So let us come to the next topic, children, that we will see here. Do you know, when a gas sphere contracts, its temperature increases. This happens because of the transformation of its gravitational potential energy into heat energy. So whatever energy is stored there, that change into heat energy. Now more than one star can be produced by contraction of a huge interstellar cloud. Now here you can see in this figure, thousands of stars are there in this. And most of are formed from the one single gigantic interstellar clouds. Now, next is the stability of the star. Or how stable it is. If you burn an incense stick, you can know, you can smell the fragrance or smell all over the room. Same way, if we remove the lid of the vessel of boiling water, the steam is spread all over in surrounding. Same way here, that whatever gas is present in the stars, that did it disperse in the space, or the properties of sun remain unchanged over the last 4.5 billion years ago. These all are the questions which are due to the, we can get the answer due to the gravitational force, or the reason is gravitational force, because the gravitational force between these gas particle of the stars keep these particles together. If the gravitational force, which is constantly trying to bring the gas particle close together, and the pressure of the hot gas, which is constantly trying to disperse the gas, these both are balanced, then the star remains stable. And sometime when the gravitational force acting inwards toward the center, while the star's gas pressure is acting outward. So this outward and inward force is balancing to the this star, and that is away from the center of the stars this gas pressure is working. So that is why the balancing is there. Now you can see in this figure, it is shown here that in the gravitational force, you can see it is inside, see inside it is, while the pressure of gas is outside. Now sometime you might have played the tug of war. What is a tug of war? A rope, suppose one side 5 students are there, other side 5 students are there, and they are just holding the two ends of the, 5 students are holding the one end of the this rope, and the other 5 students are holding the other side of the rope. When the forces applied by both sides are equal, they balance each other, and the center of the rope always remain static. Sometime what happens, suppose one side the students number will increase, then the rope will just shift toward that side. So same case happen in case of the star. Gravitational force and gas pressure are balanced, so the star is stable. So this point you have to underline, why the stars are stable. But which one of them is more than the other, the star either contract or expand. Now if there was no gas pressure in the sun, then it will collapse to a point in 1 or 2 hours. Gas pressure depend on the density and temperature of the gas. Higher the temperature and density, higher will be the pressure. So this you have to learn this point. Now come to the next point. This is evolution of the stars. We'll see evolution of the star. Evolution of star means change in its properties with the time, which is resulting in passing through the different stages. That we have seen the properties of the sun, and sun have not changed the past 4.5 billion years. Stars evolve very slowly for most of their lifetime, and as the stars are continuously emitting the energy, therefore their energy is constantly decreasing. So this point also you have to underline, that as the stars continuously emitting energy, so their energy is decreasing. For their stability to remain intact, that is maintaining a balance between the gas pressure and the gravitational force, it is necessary that the temperature remain constant. So this also you have to underline, children. Now, for the temperature to remain constant, energy must be generated inside the stars, and this generation of energy occurs because of the burning of the fuel at the center of the star. So I will show you the slide how the burning take place in the center in the end of this lecture. The reason for evolution of star is burning of the, therefore the decrease in the amount of the fuel will be there in the center. So when the fuel in the center finish, the energy generation also stop. So this also you have to underline. And as a result the temperature of star start decreasing. Due to the decrease in temperature, the gas pressure also decreases, and the balance between the gravitational force and gas pressure become unbalanced. It cannot be maintained. So as the gravitational force is now higher than the gas pressure, the star starts contracting. This causes another fuel to start burning. When hydrogen at the center is finished, then helium also start undergoing fusion and energy generation start again. So that is how the many fuels will be used depending on the mass of the stars. So here this is the figure. You can see how the evolution of the stars is based on their mass and their end stages. So here you can see these are the interstellar clouds. They change into high mass stars, then it goes to the supergiant, then supernova, then your black hole are formed, then how the neutrons are there, how the fusion and all takes place, white dwarf is formed. So full life cycle of the star is shown here. Now these are the, here we'll see children, one more para is there, that higher the mass of the star, higher is the number of fuels which is used. During this, a lot of the changes occur in the stars. As a number of processes occur inside the stars, it sometime contract and expand at the time when the star goes through the different stages. That stage is already seen. When all possible fuels are exhausted, the energy which is generated finally stops. And due to that, the temperature of the star start decreasing, and the balance between this gas pressure and gravitational force cannot be maintained. So let us see now the evolution of star ends. That is how the evolution of star end, and what the end stages are, that we'll see now. End stages of star: the higher the mass of the star, faster is its rate of evolution. Now the different stages during the evolution of the stars, which is the path of the evolution of star, also depend on its mass also. So we have seen that when the energy generation stops, the temperature also decreases, and which causes the gas pressure to decrease. So but natural, when the temperature decreases, the gas pressure also decreases, the star will contract and its density also increases. Anything contract, like if the liquid is changing to solid, it contract, that is why it is changing to solid, and solid's density is more than the liquid. Same way here, when it contracts, the density become more. In such cases, the gas pressure remain constant even after the energy generation stops completely, and the temperature of the gas goes on decreasing. The stability of the star can remain intact forever, and this can be considered the end stage of the stars. So there are the three ways of the evolution of star depending on their initial mass. Initial mean whatever mass was there in the starting. We can divide the stars in three groups. The path of the evolution and the end stage of all stars is the same in same group is the same. So let us see now. Here the end stage of stars having initial mass, that is it is less than 8 times the mass of the sun. So stars in this group undergo huge expansion, and their radius also increases by a factor of 100 to 200. In this stage they are called the red giant stars, that already you have seen. In this stage they are called as red giant stars. This name is given because of the large size and because of the fact that the stars look reddish due to their lower temperature. The size of red giant star in comparison to other type of stars is there in 19.2 figure. You have to see, children. This you can see, children. This is the figure. This is the figure you can see. The red giant star. Now, let us see the second one. That is end stage of star having mass between 8 and 25 times the mass of the sun. So these stars also go through the red giant stage and later through the super giant stage, during which their size may increase 1000 times. So this point you have to underline. The huge explosion of the supernova explosion, which occurs at last, and that is very powerful, and so much energy is given off that we can see the stars during the day also. That is why the central portion, which is left behind after the explosion, contract and its size become as small as about 10 kilometer. In this state, the stars are completely made up of neutrons and are called neutron stars. So we can see here, this point you have to underline. The pressure of these neutrons is independent of the temperature. That means it doesn't depend on the temperature and it is capable of balancing the gravitational force forever. So this is also important point that you have to underline. Neutron stars is the end stage of these stars. This is also important point. Now children, you can see here a recent picture of the supernova explosion, which was first seen in 10548. Now this is the pic what you can see here. Now as the size of the white dwarf is this this content is omitted for you, but you have to just see, study yourself. Now children, here the third stage is there, that is end stage of the stars having mass larger than 25 times the mass of the sun. These stars evolve like the stars in the second group, but after the supernova explosion, no pressure is capable of balancing their huge gravitational force, and that is why they continue contracting forever. And when their size become smaller, their density and their gravitational force also increases tremendously. So all nearby objects get attracted toward these stars and nothing can come out of them, not even light also. So any light which is falling on these stars does not get reflected and get absorbed inside the stars. So we cannot see the stars at all, but we can see a minute black hole at its place. And this end stage of the star is therefore called a black hole. So this is very important point that you have to underline. So we have seen all stages, all three stages. Now here one table is given that you have to study, children. Your chapter explanation is over. I'll give you notes in the next lecture. Thank you, children. If any doubt is there, you can ask me, you can message me, you can ask me. Thank you, children.